se recibieron una llamada, seguramente de un dedo. Vaya abriéndome la cajuela, si no te voy a empulgar de lo nuevo. Va por encima hacia el norte, llevo un clavo enterrado.
En los huevos.
Good morning, Panama! It's 5 o'clock in the morning here in Panama and we're about to set off this phase two of our evacuation plan. Phase one complete. Sketchiest boat ride of our lives up a shallow, rapid river. Now we're about to take on the donkey phase.
I pretend I have no idea what I'm letting myself in for. But at the same time, I know exactly what I'm letting myself in for. And that's what's scaring me about it.
Well, I really want to make a difference in the conservation world. I studied at university for 3 years. I studied biology at school all the way through. And when Rob approached me with the idea to travel to Panama and break this record, but at the same time, get involved in some wildlife groups here and, well, hopefully make some groundbreaking research. It was an offer I couldn't refuse.
I've got dreams. I'm going for them. And you know, even if this year turns out to be a total failure, at least I've taken my passion and I've acted on it.
The focus really is on the Antillean Manatee. Lenin Raquelmi, who we're working with, believes there to be manatees in some of the rivers. So he's highlighted 5 or 6 rivers for us to survey.
See, when you think of them as sea cows, I think that the term definitely fits. Because they are herders, because they move as herds usually, and they are like cows. They are moving from one pasture area to the other, so to speak.
What we're doing is we can actually, on the prone paddleboards, go in silently up the rivers without disturbing the manatee and hopefully find them.
Now you guys found out something about manatees in this area, that'll be it. You guys will be the discoverers of this.
We hope so.
Should be amazing.
You'll be the ones.
After months of back-breaking training, just getting the boards out of customs and up to the start line was an adventure in itself. We had $300 between us to last for the next 3 months, and the boards had been held up so long in customs that we didn't actually know if they'd float with all our kit on. So what better day to find out and to start the journey than April Fool's Day? Starting in Cahuita National Park, Costa Rica, we head southeast across the border into Panama.
We intend to circumnavigate the Bocas del Toro archipelago before traversing the mangrove swamps of the Laguna de Chiriqui.
The first of our 12 manatee surveys will take place here at Rio Manatee.
Following the headland, we will take a small detour to the untouched and idyllic island of Escudo,
rejoining a treacherous, shark-infested and surf-exposed coastline all the way to Calovibora.
Okay, here we are, about to start. We're in Cahuita, beautiful national park. Excited, can't wait to get going.
Better float now.
So embarrassing. Setting off, baby, April 1st.
Alright, she floats.
There are a lot of dangers involved in this trip. It's a journey into the unknown. No one's ever done a paddleboarding journey quite like this. It's not just about the long distance record, it's a journey into a really inhospitable area of the world. Sharks in the ocean, crocs in the ocean, caimans in the rivers. I mean, my biggest fear is that something could happen to Aaron and I would feel eternally guilty if that did happen. We're expecting some hardship, as with any adventure, any expedition. You know, it's not truly an adventure until something goes wrong, and I have no doubt that it won't take us long to find some form of mischief.
The sand is blisteringly hot.
After a successful 12.8 miles paddled on day one in blistering heat, things took a turn for the worse.
Rob and I have been planning this expedition for months now. And then the first day, first night, we get Rob, it just makes you think, is it all worth it? Had it been one of our big bags, that pretty much would have been game over.
This morning when we've woken up, just getting out of the tent and stretching your legs, it feels like when you stretch your leg out straight, it feels like the skin's gonna tear and we're gonna have to paddle in trousers from here on in, at least until they recover. So yeah, pretty steep learning curve and a tough introduction to the sun 9 degrees from the equator.
Venturing on, we were able to put our early struggles behind us. Things were only gonna get better for the Panama Paddle Expedition team. Next stop, Bocas.
So we're back to where it all began. We're just back from Red Frog Beach. This is where we came 5 years ago. We found tons and tons of strawberry dart frogs, tiny little things, beautiful creature. This time we've come back and saw almost nothing. So we're heading south now with a view to surveying manatee in areas that haven't yet been exposed to the tourist industry here. We decided to leave the charts at home and go with the traditional map with some more imagery so that we could process it better.
It's more piratey.
We left Red Frog Beach early in the morning and literally had no idea how long it would take us to get to the treasure or the big tree. If we keep heading in here, we should find the big boats and that should take us home and back to Bocas town.
Just follow the big blue boats. We joke, but this is genuinely the map that we have been following for the last 5 days.
We've been paddling for 2 weeks, and yesterday we completed our 100 miles. That's a ton, England. And we're going to celebrate.
We're going to hit an infamous nightclub on the ocean front called Aqua Lounge.
The paddle home should be pretty interesting.
Kids, don't drink and paddle.
Try another one and eat the whole bean.
Yes.
Okay, so there's a lovely little left wedge outside those rocks over there, and Aaron hasn't gone left yet on this trip, so...
Struggling with lefts in my life, actually.
So, Aaron, are you confident about this next surf session?
Well, if there's a right out there, I'll definitely find it.
Okay, so amazingly, we've just found strawberry dart frog of Bastimentos, and that's a great omen. If we can find these frogs, then maybe we can find some manatee further down the coast. Wow, that's amazing!
Hello, welcome to Aaron and Rob's Island Paradise. This is the front. And this is the back.
After the heights of Bocas, we now had to negotiate Panama's mangrove maze.
This is night number 3 in the mangrove. And things aren't getting any better. We're camped out on this jetty because that's where we finished up tonight, and there was no other option, apart from this rotten old jetty. And we seem to arrive just on midge or chitra hour every day. And you cover up as much as you can. Head nets are useless, the holes are too big. So we got a buff right over our head. They just try and get you in the eyes constantly. And tuck your shirt in at the back, and that's another spot they love to get up, bite the top of your bum crack, which is incredibly itchy. Get up in there, in the eyes, in the mouth, up the nose. It's just pretty awful. Swarms of them.
But we are making jungle hot chocolate.
I'm turning it around.
Which is spaghetti water.
And sweet corn water leftovers.
And sweet corn water with some cocoa powder, which is the sweetest cocoa powder you will ever taste.
So we'll probably have about a shot each, just to boost the morale.
So Rob, would you like to explain the situation here?
fucking unbearable.
I can't even hold the camera straight.
And vamonos. Finding our way out of the mangroves, we made it to our supply drop in Triqui Grande.
$12 a night. Still got $1 to pay. $1 más. Gracias.
Welcome to our room.
We've had to come to Triqui Grande because we've left our supplies here. So we treat ourselves to a night of luxury in this luxurious hotel you can see.
But we do have electricity, so we're charging up the GoPro.
Just been making use of the ensuite facilities.
The primary reason for this room being a somewhat untoward activity. We've noticed how reinforced the bed actually is. I mean, you've got a, what is that, a half inch chipboard? Reinforced with struts, braces. That is not going anywhere. There's no giving that.
No noise?
No noise, no creak, no movement.
It's gonna be a quiet night.
Just in case you want a friend to watch, you've got the bunk beds for two friends to watch. $12 a night in Panama, this is what you get.
Cheapest room we found.
It is, and for a reason.
After realizing that most customers pay by the hour and not the night, we hastily loaded the paddleboards and cast anchor. Our ever-present adoring fans were there to cheer us away.
The first river to survey, and we thought a logical place to start, was Rio Manatee, which we were hopeful wasn't just a historical reference. And then this is where we slept last night. You walk across our gangplank to get to the combination. Aaron's just writing some inspired poetry.
Manatee-inspired
poetry. Yeah. And a few words for the people back home.
Well, there's nothing on my page yet. But it's going to be something along the lines of manatee. Such a beautiful creature, but so difficult to find. So on.
Sweet and simple.
Yeah.
And we'll take you down here. Got a lady beating out her clothes to wash them. We've got all our stuff drying over here. And the solar juice charging the camera so we can get some photos of the manatee. So yeah, what a really nice little village here.
Come on, boy.
It didn't take long to make friends with some inquisitive locals, and beating the chief at an arm wrestle secured us some extra manpower to help with the surveys. Unfortunately, our impressive fleet was enough to scare off Bigfoot, let alone timid manatee.
Such is the way with the raining season in Panama that it didn't take long for the weather to change. It was time to paddle up river solo, drift down, and take stock of our majestic surroundings.
The reeds up there is where the manatee is supposed to be living and eating. And this is just raw jungle on our left, all around us. And we're drifting along at about 1 knot. First survey of manatee on the current paddleboards in history. That's pretty bloody cool. Got my feet dangling. Alligator and caiman infested and croc infested water. And there he is. Fortunately, that's right where we just saw the manatee.
Rob's just cooking up breakfast this morning. Oh, look at that.
celebrations continue. We've got some apricots from Rob's grandma.
How's your brew, mate?
Takes me home. Do a splash of milk, cream. You've got to make do, haven't you? It's a hard life out here in the jungle.
After treating ourselves to a few home comforts, celebrations continued as we reached 150 miles in choppy, murky seas.
I'll show you this chop from here. Unfortunately, our course completely diagonal to the chop, so it's about as bad as it can get. But it's too short, so you don't fit in it. It doesn't help you at all. It just buffers the boat the whole time.
What's significant about today?
We've just reached halfway to a Guinness World Record. So, 177 miles in, come on.
Leaving Kusaping, it's 2:30 in the afternoon. We got a big old paddle to Tobobe, around the point. Maybe 4 hours, it's gonna be touch and go whether we get there before dark.
Bit of swell around today, which is slightly concerning for our next leg, which is pretty exposed.
Rob and I have just spied our own private island in the Caribbean.
Paradise found! This is private island number 2, and let's just say it's a bit of an upgrade from the first island. It's literally the coolest place we've ever been to. Speechless.
It's awe-inspiring. You couldn't paint a better picture.
Quite an amazing paddle today. We started right over around that corner there and come all the way along this coastline, which was absolutely stunning, and around here, and we've come up onto the beach here, and quite honestly, this is the most amazing place I've ever been to in my whole life. Just been to the Hissing Rock, which was incredible as well. So you stand over this rock, it's got a spray up in your face.
Let me go down. That's amazing, you went for it.
That's huge! That's huge! Boom! Yeah!
Go, 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 Kate!
There you go. Hey, that's what I'm looking for. Woo! Yeah!
I bet I'm damaging my elbow, paddling. Kids, it's a bad idea to around.
It's for the documentary.
And because we paddled up to it, it felt like we discovered it, so I'm sure hundreds of people have been here before, but for us this is a new discovery and absolutely amazing. So, mind blowing.
Have we mentioned before how quickly things can change in Panama? One thing this coastline is notorious for is drug smuggling.
Go, 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 go.
We were finding this out firsthand. All we could do was hide and pray we wouldn't be found. In the morning, we had no idea if the kit or our unwanted company would still be there.
We were so lucky, and genuinely, that was
scariest night of my life, and we're pretty lucky to be alive. Had they encountered us, they shoot to kill without thinking.
So the smugglers came right up to here, had their torches on, they were shining the light up to there, which is about where we were camped, and somehow we managed to evade them. We should have known the reason it was so easy to come in on the paddleboards is exactly the same reason it's so easy for a boat to pull in. The rocks are all where they should be, they're all out of the point there. Smuggler's Haven.
Miles from safety, there was no choice but to keep our heads down and paddle on.
Okay, so we're on the way to scoot over Arguas. It's quite rough. Rob's bailing out with the mess tin. We're about a foot deep in water here. We've got high seas. We're going down. Mayday!
So today we're on the hunt for the pygmy sloth that lives on a scudo, and we're just trying to hike over to the other side of the island, which is
a quagmire.
As difficult as it looks, he said. Definitely take a guide with you when you go to a scudo. Yeah. But our boat captain was our guide, and he's buggered off and left us, so off we go. Exploring this place.
That way.
And Aaron Ford is transformed into Araconda.
So I look super badass now.
Yeah.
Rambo.
Belong in the jungle.
Rambo.
Pow!
You look a bit. Your hair looks a bit like Napoleon Dynamite at the moment.
I'm probably closer to Napoleon Dynamite than I am to Rambo.
Well, I've been going 6 weeks now. It's bound to take its toll.
That's the secret to all expeditioning. Parts of it are absolutely incredible. With hindsight, all of it is incredible. But at the time, a lot of it's tough going. But we're doing it. And we're showing what you can do with a little budget and a lot of imagination. So that's
and a lot of drive.
That's exactly what we wanted to do. So here you have it.
Sloth watching with Rogue Lee Cunliffe.
Beating back the jungle, Araconda.
Day for a paddle. I think it starts
in the early morning. Really is stunning here. It's hard to capture on film, but it's one of the most beautiful islands in the world. Surrounded by coral reef, so the interior is this big sheltered lagoon-like area full of mangrove and golden beaches. Really is stunning. Today from our prone paddleboards, it's not manatee that we've been searching for, it's the pygmy sloth of Esculoda viraguis, much like its three-toed cousin on the mainland, except smaller. It's evolved to be smaller because the island's much smaller, much less vegetation. It eats exclusively mangrove, just here. And so it's evolved to have a smaller body mass, allowing it to survive here. It's pygmy, and we're hoping we can spot one or two. There's only 180 left. Really, they're critically endangered. So good luck to us.
Any sloths?
No. Looks like good habitat though. I'm sure it won't be long until we see
them. We'll try down that way. just nudged down this mangrove estuary. If you look up there in the trees, there he is, just slowly, slowly crawling up the branch away from me. You see that chap?
He's right above us. We found him on the paddleboards again, it's absolutely amazing. And check him out. There you have it, guys. The pygmy three-toed sloth of Escudo de Viragus. And what an amazing creature it is.
What an amazing experience to be this close to it.
To be this close to it, to find it on paddleboards after 5 hours of paddling up and down mangroves.
There's no one here. This is no safari. This is nature spotted in its rawest sense.
I hope it doesn't poop on my head.
Yeah, we're actually on the way to Punta Tiburon, which means Shark Point. And we're quite far out, and the mist is so heavy, we've just lost a point of view on the coast. We can't actually see the coast right now. So we're paddling blind.
After winning the trust of the locals, it was time to continue the search for manatee.
We're at Rio Canya, and we're heading up to the lagoon Jugli and Damani, which are two huge lagoons, about 10 miles inland. So Aaron's been given the most western paddle that they could find in the village, and it's about 2 hours to get up there, so it's a long old trek. How you feeling, mate?
Well, here at the Panama Paddle Expedition, even on our days off, we like to paddle. Midday. Perfect time to go for a 2 hour kayak into the wilderness. No breakfast, no lunch with us, a few power bars. Oh, loving it.
But it's a really nice river.
It's beauty.
I feel like King Kogunumbun sat in the middle while these two fellas are paddling. It's great. My turn in a minute though. Not even a ripple. So we've been to the Casa de Manatee and there was nobody at home, so we've come to another manatee playground, the Laguna Jugli, and it doesn't look like there's anything here either. We're a bit gutted really, everyone was saying that there were manatee here. We haven't seen a single sign yet.
Eight, nine hours on the water today. We're absolutely fried, sunburnt and pretty tired and hungry, had no lunch. And no manatees, which is the worst thing. Left Rio Canya and started the longest beach in Panama, which we just got told is 25 kilometers to walk to the other end, but on these boats you can probably add a third to that, and there's some gorgeous mountains in the background. Makes it a little bit more exciting than just a beach.
It's gonna be two days probably to get along this beach.
Yeah.
2 day paddle. Whoa, it's hot today. You can see the eyes are stinging with the salt and the sun already, so time to get the shades back on. It's about 9 o'clock in the morning and it's already a swelter. We've just seen a huge shark right underneath us.
Where are you, Sharky?
This, we're heading in. That was terrifying.
Still gonna try. just flipping over and yeah, I was feeling really deep water. No, it's where that shark was. Basically, I'm actually alive, I've lost my sunglasses, but oh my gosh.
That was scary. That's the most scared I've been on the trip since the bandit night.
All sharks evade here on the Panama paddle expedition. One.
This is Playa Tigra, one of the leatherback turtles most important nesting sites. And as we came in quickly to avoid the bull shark that was circling beneath us, we've noticed loads of tracks and nests all along the beach. So we're going to stay out tonight and hopefully find some.
Wow.
Despite finding this magnificent creature, we still haven't found any manatee since the first river we'd surveyed. With only 5 of 12 rivers left, time was running out.
We need a lull badly.
Nervously paddling back out into shark-infested waters, an altogether different challenge strikes that brings the whole expedition under threat.
Feeling's pretty low here today in the camp.
Not very comfortable at the moment, let's put it that way.
Rob pooed himself in the night again, doesn't want to eat anything.
First time I felt really bummed out, really. I had dysentery all yesterday afternoon, continued all through the night. Feeling really low actually, not got much energy at all. And yeah, it's just 43 days now in the tropics and it's starting to take its toll on my body.
Just can't wait to be done.
Okay, so Panama is not where you want to be when you've got a dodgy stomach. Crouched down here. Further down the beach, I've just showed you how close everyone is, there's nowhere else to go. And I feel like I'm gonna
Rob's having a bit of a tricky toilet situation today. So he decided to make a dash from dinner, way into the distance. Into the sunset he goes for 10 minutes. That's about the sixth time today that he's been. So.
That's exactly where you don't want to get ill. We're the furthest point from anywhere on the entire trip, really. No one's even got a motorised boat here, it's all just cayucos. So if things were to go wrong, you're a long, long way from help. And it appears that I'm slightly ill, not too bad. I've only got 20 miles to paddle, so we're gonna make quick sharp and get out of here. I mean, these guys are looking at the map as though it's the first time they've seen a map. So it's pretty rural out here.
Another shark sighting brought an early close to the day's paddling. Little did we know that the true danger would be altogether more domestic.
That's not a smile. That's a grimace.
About as much of a smile as you get out here from the locals.
Whilst cooking dinner, the stove gave way, pouring a canteen full of boiling water onto Rob's feet.
Just not a great situation to be in, two burnt feet and the squit. Makes running out in the night pretty tricky. This is the worst pain I've ever had. We've been running at a massive calorie deficit now for 45 days in a row, and it's only when you get ill that it really hits you and it really strikes you just how low we are. Both noticed each other getting extremely skinny, and since I've had dysentery, I've been feeling so weak, and my paddling endurance has really dropped, not helping that my foot is completely scalded and blistered. We're absolutely miles from a hospital when I burnt my foot. So we've done the best with our medical kit that we could do. We've patched it up, and hopefully it's enough to get us back there without getting infected. With our backs to the wall and 100 miles since our last sighting, we're beginning to lose hope of ever seeing a manatee again.
This is when Batista, the crazy manatee whisperer of the Comarca and Gobe Bugle, appeared from the bushes proclaiming that at 7 p.m. sharp, the manatee would appear.
We paddled out to investigate, not believing him for 1 second.
And sure enough, we found what we were looking for. You can see in this picture the tip of a manatee's rostrum.
Well, we've seen them at either end of our route. Could all be connected. If they just float up and down the coast, they could be interbreeding, it could be separate populations, it could be one big population that moves down. And who knows, there could be any number of manatee in the rivers between, which we just didn't happen to see on that day. And Rob's looking like he's calling it a day. Hopefully the morning brings a bit more luck and we can get some GoPro footage, but and that was absolutely brilliant to get on film.
And I've got to say, this is a fantastic temp.
Whoa, a storm is brewing outside. No paddling for a little while yet. It's torrential rain and wind. Some of the worst we've had all trip. No manatee to spot this morning because it's too windy. And it's a morning in the tent for us two lucky lads. As if we don't spend enough time together already.
While we sit out the rain, we've made breakfast inside the tent. So it's cold porridge this morning. But we got a special treat thanks to the local here, who brought us a lovely bunch of bananas last night.
So the whole way down this coastline, people have been thinking we're narco traffickers, and we've been treated with an awful lot of suspicion and not a lot of smiles. And we are, you bastards! Look at all these drugs! We're finally getting high on our own supply. Some codeine there, some ibuprofen, some antibiotics. What a fruity mix. Oh, yes. Oh, that was a good one. That is how strong, fit men wake up in the morning. Cold porridge, bananas, and drugs.
You may think the Caribbean's all sunny weather and lovely calm seas, but I tell you it's not. Not in the raining season. But this is the last day in the Caribbean. And it's been an adventure, it's been a dream trip, but we're both glad to be getting off this coastline today.
All seriousness, 305 glorious miles in the Caribbean, two populations of manatee discovered, and what an adventure.
Beautiful sights all the way down.
It's been scary, it's been fun, it's been the adventure of a lifetime.
Testing.
We are glad.
Stoked by finding a new manatee population and with the world record in sight, nothing was going to stop us now.
We just had the worst beach of the entire 46 days on the final day of the Caribbean.
We're 1 mile from finishing and Aaron goes and tries to get barreled on Big Bird. And it didn't work out very well. Squall came through, waves got bigger and bigger. If you have a look now, this is exactly what came and got us. One of those sets.
Well, it's a very sad day for us both. And, yeah. I don't know what to say, absolutely gutted.
So Aaron's just getting a little souvenir. There's no way we can carry this board back, so we're just going to keep a memento and leave the rest with these guys. Completely finished.
It was time to get out of here.
Rio Calavabora and the end of the line for Big Bird. Looking a bit shorter than our other board.
Yourself a couple of combat strikes and put Audio Slave in your ears and crack on.
So we finally made it. Rob's arse is sore, my everything is sore. This is what we're looking for.
Bus terminal in Panama City at about 11 o'clock. Preparing to sleep there for the night, and I took the dressings off my feet. Realised one foot had become incredibly swollen and hot, and it pushed all the way up to my ankle and was starting to come up my leg. So I was pretty concerned at this point. I was worried that I had some nasty tropical bizarre infection that was going to end up having my foot cut off. So jumped in a taxi straight to hospital. Got here. Put straight on an IV drip. Been stuck on some opiates since then. All is well. Feet are so nice and snug now. Being dressed twice a day, which is slightly better than Nurse Aaron Nightingale can manage. I'm sure he doesn't want to have to wrap my feet up every day. Another 5 days in here. I can't wait to get out. And then the paddle continues. We have unfinished business. Got another 30 odd miles to go to break this world record. So as soon as the feet are okay, and get back out there and finish the job we started. Can't wait.
greatest achievement of our lifetimes, probably in our lifetimes.
This is it.
All those naysayers back in England. Oh, are you sure you haven't bitten off more than you can chew?
No, we haven't! Come on!
What about the crocodiles and the sharks?